Welcome to Whiteboard Programming, where we simplify programming with easy to understand whiteboard videos. And today I'll be sharing with you what is a blockchain protocol, why a blockchain even needs one, along with top 5 blockchain protocols that you should know about. So let's get started. First, let's understand what is a protocol. Well, a protocol is a set of rules and guidelines that are used to achieve a particular task and aims to provide a framework for data transfer over the internet. These rules are necessary to ensure that data can be transferred efficiently. Moreover, protocols are meant to work like this, and nothing is different in case of blockchain too. The only thing to note is that the blockchain protocols are designed to maintain different aspects of blockchain, primarily in an enterprise. This means that there are blockchain security protocols, network protocols, and blockchain consensus protocols as well. All these protocols, when combined, mainly become a blockchain framework. So I hope you got a fresh start here. Before going further, let's discuss why does blockchain need a protocol in the first place. To provide clarity here, we all must realize that the core idea behind blockchain is its decentralized nature. But this means that centralized authority is absent, and simply to make it work as intended, protocols are used. That is, as there is no centralized entity, peers or nodes need to be connected and maintain a ledger copy. And on top of it, there's a consensus method also employed, which works in the network to validate transactions into blocks. Do remember that once these blocks are created, they cannot be altered. And all of this is achieved using blockchain protocols, as it acts as a guideline for the complete network. Next, let's talk about top enterprise blockchain protocols that you should know about. Number 1. Hyperledger. Hyperledger is an open source enterprise framework and is managed by Linux Foundation. It is an umbrella project which has tons of frameworks and protocols in it that a business can use. As it is open source, anyone with the right expertise can contribute to the project. And just to let you know, Hyperledger is all about permission blockchain. The main aim here is to provide enterprise blockchain solutions a universal framework or guidelines for blockchain implementation. And the good news is that there are many tech giants that are currently participating in this project, working on the same vision of creating a protocol that can be followed by enterprise solutions. It was created back in 2015, and right now more than 260 organizations are working towards creating an industry-grade enterprise solution. Further, Hyperledger has strong security blockchain protocols, and one of their projects, Hyperledger Fabric, is really popular among the enterprises. Some of the benefits of using Hyperledger include: first, it offers enhanced productivity with the help of frameworks and tools. Second, you will find good quality code for implementation due to its open source nature. Third, it's better at handling intellectual property. And last but not the least, it offers a collaborative approach. Next, number 2, Quorum. Now, Quorum is yet another enterprise blockchain protocol that is aimed to solve finance sector problems. JP Morgan invented Quorum, which can be described as an enterprise-focused Ethereum blockchain. And to state simply, this protocol-based system is key when it comes to solving finance-related problems. It can change how financial enterprises function and implement blockchain in-house. Quorum, just like Hyperledger, is an open-source project and is available under LGPL 3.0 license. It also benefits from Ethereum architecture and its approach. Further, with more than 10,000 commits till date, it is growing into one of the best possible enterprise blockchain framework for businesses. Also, it can be used for other industries and use cases as well, and its protocol-based design makes it possible to serve permissioned networks better. Next, Quorum architecture includes three important components: Quorum Node, Constellation Transaction Management, and Enclave. And it primarily uses the RAF-based consensus and Istanbul BFT for its functioning. The key features of Quorum blockchain include the following. Number 1, it offers better performance. Number 2, it makes use of voting-based consensus mechanisms. Number 3, it's open source and fairly mature for an organizational application. Number 4, it offers trustworthy network and is enterprise-ready for implementation. Number 5, it offers enhanced transaction and contract privacy. Next on the list is Coda. Now, this is also a promising enterprise protocol that is built from scratch. It is handled by R3 Banking Consortium and is best suited for banking and finance-related organizations. It utilizes distributed ledger software along with consensus algorithm to ensure transparency, traceability, and transaction validation. Coda offers smart contracts, which means that most of the banking solutions can be automated. The principal or key features of R3 Coda include the following. Number 1, it has the ability to create smart contracts. Number 2, it offers unique services and timestamping with node tree pools. Number 3, there's a flow framework that enables enterprise to write complex protocols and make them work with different user levels. Number 4, Corda, just like any other blockchain protocol discussed until now, is open source and permissioned. This makes it an ideal solution for enterprises that want to make most out of the Corda R3 architecture. The 5 key standards of Corda architecture include the following: longevity, secure, stable, scale, and interoperable. Next on the list is Enterprise Ethereum. Now, Ethereum is one of the best public blockchain platforms out there. It offers a wide range of features including smart contracts, decentralized app creation, and much more. However, to make it feasible for an enterprise, it needs to be permissioned. This is where Enterprise Ethereum comes in. In reality, it lets enterprises create private permissioned networks fully capable of scaling to enterprise needs. The private chains created using Enterprise Ethereum are separated from public chains, but the private chains are completely capable of interacting with the public chains if needed. The key difference between Ethereum and Enterprise Ethereum is permissioning. Therefore, Enterprise Ethereum also offers a better privacy level with improved performance and scalability to any organization. The Enterprise Ethereum Alliance maintains it, and right now there are more than 300 member companies from more than 45 countries, and the project has also gained more than 1400 individual members, which are working to making the project more scalable and effective. The key aim of Enterprise Ethereum Alliance includes the following. Number 1, open source standard. Number 2, improvisation alongside Ethereum and cross-industry development. So, next one on the list, number 5, Ripple. This enterprise blockchain platform only started their journey back in 2012. However, it was not known as Ripple when it first started its journey. Ripple was called OpenCoin and later they renamed or rebranded as Ripple in 2015. More so, RippleNet can connect banks, organizations, asset exchange using their blockchain platform and focus on a faster payment processing. The key feature of Ripple include the following. Number 1, it offers unlimited assets. Number 2, you can benefit from rapid deployment it offers. Number 3, it offers high security. Number 4, there's an option to make faster payments. Number 5, it offers liquidity solutions. Number 6, one can employ modernized messaging as well. And last but not the least, it's very developer friendly. The Ripple is best suited for enterprise companies within the financial sector. Some of the most popular users of this protocol include the following. Lastly, I'd like to say that there has been a rapid growth in the past decade when it comes to blockchain technology, and so many blockchain protocols have evolved at a rapid pace. Every sector, including supply chain, healthcare, finance, etc., are using protocol-based blockchain solutions to better manage their business use case, and that's why it's important to understand the individual importance of enterprise blockchain protocols in order to stay ahead of your learning curve. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you love my content, feel free to smash that like button, and if you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.